Hi all, good morning. So let's do the prayers first. Again, the left hand up, the right hand down. So creating a beautiful energy circle. And with the COVID, we will do more prayers towards building our own immunity. So Father, Mother, God, creator of all that is, thank you so much for this beautiful divine knowledge and the beauty that you shower on the world, allowing each one of us to remain connected to you, to accept our own power, to remain connected to our higher self, to walk on our own life plan without knowingly or unknowingly attracting any sort of disease, sickness, or any chaotic situation in our lives, and that to know that it is possible, allowing ourselves to flow with the flow of the universe and allowing ourselves to be in complete synchronicity with the divine universal force, connecting to the energy of the pure love, the energy of the seventh plane, of the pure wisdom and the pure intellect. Thank you. Aha. Let's start with the question answer sessions. If whoever wants to ask, like if you can just raise your hand. So from our team, they will just unmute yours, mention your name. So Pratibha. So Pratibha, can you?
Yes, I've unmuted.
Ankita will be unmuting, yes.
Yeah, unmuted. So here are a few questions. The first thing is, so from the time I started this, I've noticed that when I close my eyes and have my hands on my eyes, my body tends to move sideward because of the energy. Okay. Is this an indication of anything? That's one question. Second question is,
let me answer the first one.
Okay.
So that's not an indication. That depends a lot on if you are actually following some other meditations also or not. Because apart from that, we all are that divine spark of the love. So if I am becoming who I am, my body should not have any problem. But unless and until I do not recognize my own self, so then something, I just see that divine energy as something else and not my own energy. Okay. And then my body may distinguish it and fight. So the more you will think that I am the divine spark of the love, your body will be in sync with it and it will be a very beautiful, easy process for you. Your body should not throw any sort of symptoms or like moving here and there. Yeah.
So I'm not accepting it as my divine energy. In other words, I'm not accepting the divinity.
No, but the thing is that we all are the divine spark of the God. The God is within us.
Okay.
But if we have separated it, we have made it that God, you are there, we are here.
Okay.
But that's not true. So when that oneness comes, if we are rejecting it, then my body may see, like how our immunity sees some other agent or a virus as something which is attacking, and our immunity will start, like our white cell starts attacking it. Mm. Same thing happens at the energy level. But ideally, you are that God and you are invoking that God gene into you. So just accept that I am the divine spark of the love. Just one line affirmation.
Okay.
Whoever wants, please write it down, because if you'll ask me afterwards, I won't know. So just say, I am the divine spark of the love.
Okay.
Because in reality, that is what who we are.
Okay. Second thing is, in the 4 days, I've noticed that I have slight heaviness here, left side of my neck at the back, and same left side on my upper part of the shoulder. It's just very slight. It goes off after the session is over. So...
yeah, so that actually is not because of the meditation, but normally the behind the neck pain indicates the feeling of being used. And when it comes towards the left side, it indicates the worry for the future.
Yeah, okay.
And the shoulder is a responsibility, so worry for the future. So sometimes that time, that memory triggers up and then you feel that heaviness. But then probably as the downloads and all comes, it slowly and progressively it reduces.
Okay, and then the pain between my shoulder blades on the bone.
Responsibility. Responsibility.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
I do have a lower back pain, okay? Like in my lower back in the middle, like between, we have the two dimples, yes, on the hips, right?
Right. So, see, in 20 minutes, I cannot do the personal session, okay, for anyone. And I may not even be tell everyone, you are the first one. So maybe you are getting time and I'm saying, but lower back is normally the imbalance of yin and yang and financial insecurity. Does not necessarily mean that financially you may not have money, but if from within, if the person is feeling that, and there can even be the stretch between like your spiritual self and your material self. When I say material self, it is not in a negative connotation because that's connected with the root chakra. Right. So it is the fight within myself, not with me, with somebody else.
Yes, yes.
But these are like in 20 minutes, I'm not.
Yes, I completely understand.
That's because you mentioned, so like that answer is for everyone. And I'm just mentioning to the entire group, whatever are the days we take, even the physical pain, it does not indicate that you have to have that pain. Because if mind, body are connected, as Richa explained that day. So every one of us have a part of us somewhere within us, identified or unidentified. Right. So just having that divine downloads will always help you. So it does not matter that you have to have the pain. Yeah. So Ankita, who is next?
Thank you.
Thank you. Who was next? I think Richa SM was next.
Yes, I have turned my video on, but I think there is some network issue. So am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible, Richa.
Okay. Hi, ma'am. Thank you, first of all, for this wonderful questions. And my query is, it is something personal, but I think I am not getting resolved with it. I had migraine pain since 15 years and I took a lot of medicines, allopathy, homeopathy, everything. But then finally, my spiritual journey started beginning when I conceived with my child, and I did past life regression also, but what the intensity has decreased, but now the problem is every month menses, the trigger again comes back, and I have done past life regression also. So I want to just acknowledge that why this is not going from my unconscious thing.
Okay. So, Richa, first of all, the affirmation for you will be, I accept the women in me. Because anytime anybody of you on the group who have any problem connected to your menstrual cycle, somewhere at a subconscious level, you are rejecting the women in you. Okay. Apart from that, the past life is just to even identify at a deeper level what belief you have. So probably in one or two sessions, it is difficult to clear the entire clutter. My own journey had started with migraine towards spirituality. And every time I learned more, there was a new chapter which would open up till you realize that any disease comes into your life to teach you a lesson. For example, with your migraine and with conceiving your baby, if your spiritual journey started,
yes.
So somewhere, like ideally, when you realize and you understand that, you take a call to continue learning and continue moving in your spiritual journey without you having to have migraine as a motivation for you.
Okay.
And my personal suggestion would be, please start your journey into learning more. Because when I learned more, and like, you know, there were more, like, that's why, like, today I have done like 32 levels of theta healing. So like everything where we were learning more, like right from hypnosis. So each one was giving me or empowering me with a better tool to be able to handle and to know myself better. I didn't start the journey even to heal the entire world or anything. It was just to identify who I am and why have I attracted the situation and empower myself with that. But for now, like you, please just start affirming, I accept the women in me and I release the need in me to be motivated, to be aligned with my spirituality without the migraine to be the reason for the same.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yes.
So, like to the entire class, I will just instill that feeling into you, any disease that you have. So would you all like to know what it feels like to allow yourself to be who you truly are and to be the element of the God and the divine spark of the God that you truly are, to be connected to your soul's true element of joy without you knowingly or unknowingly holding on to any of your sickness, disease, relationship issue, financial blocks as a motivational tool to move on for your further journey and to know that it is safe and it is possible and you are deserving of rescripting your life, rewriting the pages of your life filled with more awareness and choosing to rather learn the lessons of life with the energy of the pure love of the seventh plane of creator of all that is. You know how to do this with ease and grace and that it is safe, it is possible, and you are deserving of this pure love. Into every cell of your body, every area of your life, at all the four levels of your beliefs, for your highest and best, in your highest and best possible way. Thank you, it is done, it is done, it is done. Creator, show me. Please say yes in your mind to receive these feelings. And just visualize, as you visualize this beautiful, crystal clear water falling onto you along with the golden light. Any problem that you have, just they are as if it is just getting cleared and cleansed in that shower. And you see a completely new version of yourself. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Ankita, who's next?
Hi, Himani here.
Yeah, Himani.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, Sangeeta ji. So my question is why I want to know the reason why I have manifested pain in hands and legs, which keeps coming and going. It remains for 15-20 days and then goes. Plus a skin issue like pigmentation, which was never before, suddenly it appeared on my face.
So hands and legs, when you say, you talk about your palms or you talk about the
entire arms? Actually full arm and full leg, including knees, toes, feet.
And how would you describe your pain? One word.
This uncomfortable.
So somewhere you need to introspect and identify, because your hands and legs, your limbs are there to support you to move on in life. You are very handicapped if my hands are not moving, if I cannot walk without my legs. So what situations in life are you very uncomfortable while you have to move on in life? And somewhere come to a very peaceful state there. And the second thing is, again, the skin also is showing the same thing, because skin is the biggest organ in the body. So whenever there is some sort of a feeling of being attacked, the skin is the defense mechanism. So any issue, again, depending on what issue it is, it differs from person to person. Again, depending on the body part, it differs. And the pigmentation is that the ideally, as a soul, I should be glowing, but I am not glowing. And there is a pigmentation which is coming, which is again making me feel uncomfortable of myself. So just identify working in that path of why are you so uncomfortable with yourself. Yeah, because I can practically not do scan for everyone. Ideally, like what we do is we do scan. So like during classes, we teach how to do scan, identify the limiting beliefs connected to your problem, clear it and do the downloads and many more aspects attached to it, other sessions. But like I cannot do it, but this is where the issue comes from. Probably when you will work for a few days on that, that would also help you a lot. Or even simply affirming that I choose to be comfortable with myself. I accept myself in totality. And it is safe for me to be truly who I am without invoking or without feeling being attacked by. I am safe. I am secured. That would be your affirmation. You can just repeatedly go on affirming that every day like a mantra. Yeah, who is next? Yeah. Who is next?
Neeta ji.
Neeta ji, yeah, please.
Your audio is not... Neeta ji, we can't hear you. Could you type your message? I would read it out.
No. Do no. One thing, we take somebody else till then Neeta ji will type our message so that we save on time because we have only 20 minutes. Yes, is that Bhavna? Yes, hi Bhavna. Yeah, Bhavna, say what is the question?
Good morning. I just wanted to know that because of many personal questions, I just think that if sometimes I miss the session, 2-3 sessions or a week, is that okay to join again or the connectivity will be lost?
Once like you spoke so fast that I did not understand. I don't know about others. What I could make sense is sometimes because of certain personal reasons of yours, you cannot join the class every day. So is it okay? Right? Is that the question? Yeah.
Right. So the question is, it's not personal.
No, I got
it. If I join the class.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah. Understood it correctly. So sorry. Yeah. So the answer is yes, you can join anytime because like nothing is in continuation, no matter what that day we are discussing, but definitely avoid moving towards, I will afterwards listen to the recording because it's the energy healing modality. So it's the energy which matters. It is not that I come here with a planned thing. I sit here and in my meditation, I like, Creator, what is this group right now? What is needed? And you speak through me. So every day would be a different day and every day will have. So you can please join as and when it is okay if you have missed out. Thank you, Bhavna.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I'll
speak. Yeah. So Neetaji's question has come.
No. Neeta ji, you can message me the question.
Yeah, you can WhatsApp.
Question from,
you can put it on WhatsApp also. Yeah, so Monal, who is there next?
Monal.
Yeah, Monal.
Just.
Yeah, Monal, you need to unmute.
Yeah. Hello, Sangeeta ji. Hi. I have few questions. One is that if it's any chronic problem that anybody is going through, it is, if I want to do it for myself or for my family members. So usually, how much time does it take? See, I have done Reiki level 1 and crystal. So it's basically you get some sort of indication when, you know, you're giving Reiki to somebody. Is there any way that theta healing we can get to know that, you know, what is the duration that we would have to keep giving to a person, to ourself?
So first of all, I would not talk about, like, I'm not the authority to speak about Reiki, so I will not speak anything about it. Coming to theta healing, if there is a chronic problem, that is an indicator that somewhere the limiting beliefs have gone very, very, very deep. So the duration, because there is a difference between passing healing to someone and giving therapy to someone. So in the chronic problems, it is needed to take therapy or to learn yourself and work on yourself. Because the therapy is the one which will give you even the cognitive understanding of why you created the problem at the first place. Why are you choosing to hold on to that problem for yourself? And then it gives you the tools also to come out of it. How quickly you are being able to change your own mindset and take action in your life is the time depends completely on you. There are times clients have come to me with 6.7 centimeter cyst, and like in 3 hours, from the CT scan, the next MRI, like just previous day evening, shows that, and the next day MRI after the session, there is absolutely no cyst. There are times even the kidney stones, the cancer cases. So then there are times people allow themselves like the instant healing, including Vayana, who healed her cancer instantly. And there are times people may even have acidity and they take longer. So it all depends how quickly you are bringing that change.
Okay. Yeah. All right. And I have this sore throat problem since years. It's like, I think probably from my teens I started off, and it goes, it comes. So what is that more linked to?
Yes. Yeah, so throat is always about expression. And when you say sore throat, so like something constantly bothering, like the feeling is like people, you hear me out. Like, you know, and unable to be even able to take the juices of life. So it gets linked to that part of your life. Yeah, we'll quickly take like
just one more question. 30.
Time, because others will not be able, so sorry, because I have another workshop to begin at 9:30. So yes, we'll take the next person. I'll definitely take your question next time. Yeah.
No problem. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, who is next?
Amrita.
Yeah, Amrita.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
Like they always saying, I've got hypoparathyroid and hypothyroid both. And I have body aches all over. So he says the term is fibromyalgia is what they say, ki body aches hota rahega. Your calcium levels are going down. My body doesn't make calcium. So is there something for that? And my head is very heavy nowadays. And if that triggers, I don't know, it is migraine or whatever you may call. If it triggers the whole day, it's very heavy.
Okay. So whether fibromyalgia, you say thyroid, hypothyroid, anything, but let's speak about the calcium. So the calcium is something where whenever the person at a deeper level is feeling being unloved, the body is not in the capacity to absorb the calcium. So even then after that, whether you are taking supplements, whether you are taking in the injection form or any other form, even in the natural form that you are taking. So one is when you are increasing the external supply on a physical level. The second thing is, but is your body being able to absorb it? So when you will shift more of why, where is that memory and why are you feeling being unloved? And when that shifts, suddenly and majority times it comes to a lot of people from their womb memory. So next week for sure, we will do the baby in the womb exercise. I'm not saying what day, but 100% we will do the baby in the womb exercise. And the minute your body will start feeling being loved by, the automatically the receptors in the body for calcium, it increases. So everything that you mentioned, whether thyroid, parathyroid, like that is again a gland connected to expression, as that day we explained. So everything is connected there. So it moves one after the other, and that feeling heavy also needs like a lot of grounding and at a physical level to make sure that your body has more pH balance and you are not acidic. Your body is more alkaline.
I am acidic also.
You are acidic because everything you described, you do not, because everything, the jigsaw puzzle pieces are there in place. So work on a physical level more towards reducing your acidity, and on a mental and emotional level to feel being loved by. At least even affirm, I love myself in the infinity of life where I am. I am vibrating with the energy of love. I am the love. So just even if you start pampering yourself, feel being loved by, it will start showing a lot of difference, including into your fibromyalgia. Thank you, Amrita. We will next week, possibly, like I will say the earliest first, I think probably on Monday. And we will take baby in the womb exercise. And I'll guide all of you through. That is a very important exercise which has helped even chronic diseases. So that's part of theta healing.
Okay. The affirmation was very fast. So could you repeat that?
I will download that into you. So do I have the permission for each one of you to instill the feelings into you that would you like to know what it feels like to feel being loved by and let go of any resentment, any regrets, any rejections that you might be holding on to, creating the feeling of unloved into you, and to move on beyond your limitations and expectations, and that it is safe, it is possible for you to vibrate with the energy of love and be open and receptive of the energy of love. Would you like to know what it feels like to have the love for the self? And that it is completely possible, it is safe for you to live your daily life vibrating with self-love, love for others, and being open and receptive to receive love from others into every cell of your body, every area of your life, at all the four levels of your beliefs, for your highest and best, in your highest and best possible way. Thank you, it is done, it is done, it is done. Creator, show me. Please say yes into your mind as yes. I instill these feelings. Yeah, just one last question.
We have Meetaji's question that's come in.
Yeah.
Would you like to take it?
Yeah, please.
Hi, this is Meeta. I have skin issue, psoriasis in heels and around nails, itching too on the whole body.
Psoriasis, where is it?
In heels and around the nails.
Okay.
And itching too on the whole body.
Okay. So, Neetaji, as I already explained, skin is the biggest organ and a defense mechanism. But in our experience, majority of the psoriasis cases comes from a feeling of being burnt. And majority somewhere have the connection with their past life as well. There is a huge improvement when we are being able to witness what had happened there. And majority had that they were being burnt in that past life. And it generally doesn't matter because the way in which you look at the past life, it's like done. But in current reality, like your problem, you have to always connect to the present and see where are you feeling being burnt by. And the minute you start coming out of that, again, somewhere in your relationship, you feel that irritation is causing you that itching. So the itching is normally allergy, and allergy is connected to irritation. So just identify what is it that really irritates you and understand only one simple logic. Because of that, your body is constantly in that alert position and not allowing you to just let it be. So understand one thing, by holding on to irritation towards someone, by feeling being burnt by in any relationship, it does not impact anyone than you yourself. So if you really wish to come back to a normal and a healthy, happy life, you are the one responsible for it, and you have to take charge. And whether you listen to the forgiveness meditation, whether every day you just imagine the person and forgive them, but start doing that every possible day. And considering today's session, next week, I would connect baby in the womb exercise for all and even the forgiveness. So during the weekend, please write down your own list that at least who is this one person at the top that you are really angry at, because by you holding on to that anger, it's causing you a lot of harm, not to somebody else. Forgiveness is your biggest protection. And that would help you by forgiving people for what they did. That is going to help you. So next week we will do baby in the womb and forgiveness. There's two things for sure. And by just being in that energy, it would help you a lot. Thank you so much. The time is the constraint. Next Friday, I will take others. Whoever got the chance today, next Friday, we will take the other people. I have a 9:30 workshop to start teaching the theta class. So I will definitely, I'm so sorry for all the other people whom we could not consider their question and we couldn't take their question. Thank you so much. See you all on Monday, 9 o'clock sharp. Definitely make sure to join in there, and because we will be doing baby in the womb exercise. So ask more and more people if they can join in, because baby in the womb and forgiveness meditation and theta, the way in which we do, they are very, very powerful tools. And that will
help you so much.
A lot. So don't miss out
on
that part.
I missed to ask you that.
Gratitude.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.